Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about the functioning of Mac, that is nothing but multiplexed analog component. So let's begin with the topic. Mac is basically a standard that is defined for a satellite transmission of the TV signal. The high definition TV basically requires the aspect ratio which is wider than the aspect ratio required by the normal television. And therefore, it is very much important to have such standard which can be used for the proper communication of the signal. The satellite communication takes place, or the satellite signal transmission takes place, between the satellite and the antennas which are present on the earth or on the user's rooftop. So it is very much important to define certain rules or certain standards so that the communication can be happen in a proper way. So for the satellite television communication or for satellite transmission of the TV signal, European countries define a standard which is called as multiplex analog component, that is nothing but MAC. Now in this video we are going to talk about the various functioning of MAC. So let's start. So as we have just discussed, MAC stands for multiplex analog component signal, and it uses basically a interlaced scanning, and the luminance and chrominance information for each line is being scanned and it is transmitted simultaneously but not in the interleaved format. Now here luminance is nothing but the amount of light that is received by human eye irrespective of its colors. For example, if we consider a black and white picture, then in case of black and white picture, white light having more luminance than black light or dark light having less luminance. Now, when we talk about the term that is called as chrominance, the chrominance is nothing but the combination of U and the saturation. U is nothing but the predominant spectral color of the light, and it is basically used to distinguish between the color. For example, if we consider the example of green leaf, then green leaf having a green tint, or we can say green leaf having a green hue. Now, the next is nothing but the saturation. The saturation is basically used, or it defines the purity of the color. That means how much little amount of white color is get added into the color so that the color gets lighter. For example, if we consider a vivid green color, then a vivid green color having high value of saturation. That means there is no white present in the vivid green color. And when we add white color into the vivid green color, it results into the light green color, which is having very low value of saturation. So the dark color having more value of saturation and the light colors having less value of saturation. The combination of U and saturation together form a chrominance or chroma. So in case of MAC, the luminance and chrominance information about the signal is not scanned and it is not transmitted simultaneously but in the interleaved form. Now let's move on to the next, that is a separate additional carrier is being transmitted for a monophonic sound, and two additional sound carrier are transmitted for stereophonic sound. So here two different sound signals are required to be used. First one is for the monophonic sound, a separate single carrier is get transmitted, and for if the sound is stereophonic sound, then we require two additional signals, or the two additional carriers required to be transmitted. So now all these carriers will interface each other and cross luminance and cross color effect that are associated with the areas of high color saturation are get observed. So if the signal is nothing but the monophonic sound signal, then only one carrier is get transmitted. Whereas if the signal is stereophonic sound, then two signals are required to be transmitted. So then all these carriers are interfaced with each other, and the areas of cross color effect and the cross luminance effect are get observed. Now next is nothing but the MAC system allows to introduce features like digital video effect, because it maintains the video component separate by compressing the luminance and chrominance signal and then placing the signal on the same line along with the digitization sound as well as sync signal. So it is possible for the MAC system, as it uses the digital system, therefore it is, or that means the digital signal, therefore it is possible for MAC system to introduce a feature which is called as digital video effect, because of which this feature is possible because of the, as video components are get separated, or the video components are placed separated by compressing the luminance information and chrominance information into a one signal and then place it onto the digitized sound, which is also in the form of digital signal and as well as in the form of sync signal. The MAC system luminance and chrominance signal are multiplexed using TDM technique. In the basics of MAC, it is mention that the MAX system uses time division multiplexing rather than using a frequency division multiplexing. That means a particular time or the particular time slot is get allotted for a particular code. That is the generalized thing for TDM system. So for luminance and chrominance signal are multiplexed by using a TDM technique, and they are separated in time domain and sent as a separate component. This will eliminate the interference. As the signals are transmitted in a separate manner and they are encoded, or we can say they are multiplexed in the form of time division multiplexing, therefore it is very much easy to separate out these signals in a more convenient way. The MAX system uses frequency modulation with upper channel bandwidth of 24 MHz and operate in a 12 GHz frequency band. So here two frequency bands and channel bandwidth is given. That is nothing but bandwidth having value of 24 MHz and the frequency band having value of 12 GHz. The scanning period of one horizontal line is 64 microseconds, and the color and brightness signal are transmitted using sequential TDM. The next feature or the next function of MAC is, according to the digital component studio standard, the scanning frequency for luminance and chrominance signal are 13.5 MHz and 6.7 MHz respectively. That means for luminance signal, the scanning frequency is 13.5 MHz and for chrominance signal, the scanning frequency is 6.37 MHz. These frequencies are suggested that the compression factor for luminance is 1.5, whereas the compression factor for luminance signal is 3. Compression factor is nothing but the amount by which we can perform the compression on the video or audio signals. So, on the basis of this frequency, the compression factor in case of MAC standard for luminance is nothing but 1.5, and that is for chrominance, it is defined as 3. The chroma signals are time compressed by a factor of 3. The chroma signal is nothing but the chrominance signal, which is a combination of saturation and hue, and therefore it is get compressed by a factor of 3. It means their sampling rate is 6.73 MHz. There is a relationship between the compression factor and the sampling rate. So with that relationship, if the chroma factor is 3, that means the chroma compression factor is 3, then it provides a sampling rate of 6.73, which is exactly approximately double. They are written at 20.25 MHz, which is 3 times higher. After these chroma signals multiplexed in the sequential manner, thus during the forward scanning time of 64 microseconds, the signals UNV alternately occupies the 17 microsecond slot, followed by luminance signal occupied 35 microsecond slot. So here basically they define how the time division multiplexing takes place in case of MAC system. So here the 17 microsecond slot is basically given for the UNV standard, which is get alternately occupied, and 35 microsecond slot is get occupied by the luminance signal. So in this way the time division multiplexing takes place in case of MAC system. The U signal is transmitted during the odd line, and the Y signal or the V signal is get transmitted during the even line. The Y signal is nothing but the chrominance signal. The drawback of this process is that the useful vertical resolution will be limited to a smaller value. So in this case of MAC system, the vertical values which are important from the transmission point of view are get eliminated, or we can say are get limited, as the transmission is in the form of odd and even line. So these are various features. So this is what about the functioning of the MAC system, in which, let's summarize it once again. So in which if the sound signal is a monophonic sound signal, then only one carrier is transmitted. And if it is a stereophonic sound, the two signals are get transmitted. Further moving to this carrier are interfaced with each other, and cross luminance and cross color areas are get observed by the system. After that, it introduces a features of digital video error, because the compression of luminance and chrominance signal are separate and it takes place in the time division multiplexing. After that, the another important functioning about this is it provides channel bandwidth of 24 MHz and operates at the frequency band of 12 GHz. The scanning period of the horizontal line is 64 seconds, that is 64 microseconds, out of which it is get divided in such a way that the UNV alternately occurs a time period of 17 microseconds, and the luminance signal occupies the time period of 35 microseconds. The U signals are transmitted during odd line, and the Y signal, that is chrominance signal, is transmitted during even line. But the drawback of this process is that the vertical resolution, or we can say the vertical resolution, which contain all the important information, is get limited because of this process. So this is what about the functioning of MAC. So I hope you understand this topic. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda. Subscribe Ikeda. Thank you.